In the Caribbean, there are a number of active and very dangerous volcanoes. These volcanoes are located on islands in the Lesser Antilles. The island of Montserrat contains one of these dangerous volcanoes whose eruptions resulted in the destruction of its capital in 1997. The Soufriere Hills volcano is the southernmost volcano on the island of Montserrat. It is located 4 kilometers east of the capital city, Plymouth. It is the youngest volcano on the island, which has produced 3 eruptions in the last 50 years. This volcano climbs to a height of 1,050 meters and is classified as a stratovolcano. Stratovolcanoes contain alternating layers of both cooled lava and ash and tend to have relatively steep slopes. The Soufriere Hills volcanic complex began forming 170,000 years ago. It represents the most recent of 3 volcanic complexes on the island which over time have traveled to the south. For the next 40,000 years, this volcano produced a number of eruptions, including some large events which produced volcanic tuff near the top of the mountain. Then, 130,000 years ago, activity shifted 2.5 kilometers to the south to form the South Soufriere Hills volcanic complex. Eruptions during this period formed a number of volcanic cones which expanded the area of the island. Eventually, volcanic activity shifted back to the main summit and continued to build the volcano. 4,500 years ago, a 1-kilometer-wide crater formed during a highly explosive eruption. This eruption caused the summit to collapse to the east, which produced a large debris avalanche. Afterwards, the volcano would not erupt again until 1180 AD. 2 subsequent eruptions occurred soon after in the 15th and 16th centuries, creating the Castle Peak Lava Dome. For the next 4 centuries, no additional eruptions occurred, although earthquake storms hit about once every 30 years, hinting that shallow magma was still present. After a long period of dormancy, the Soufriere Hills volcano erupted on July 18, 1995. As the months continued, several additional explosions occurred. One of these explosions in late August covered Plymouth with a thick layer of ash. By December, the eruption started to build a new lava dome. By this time, most of the populace was evacuated from Montserrat's capital city. 18 months later, a massive eruption took place. A pyroclastic flow subsequently raced down the mountain to the northeast and destroyed the island's airport. Then, between August 4th and August 8th of 1997, a series of pyroclastic flows destroyed the capital. Plymouth was covered in 1.4 meters thick of ash, and many buildings not already destroyed by the eruption collapsed. As a result of these eruptions, a permanent exclusion zone was created which placed Plymouth and more than half of Montserrat off limits. Now, all of the island's residents live on the northern half of the island. This eruption was so deadly that it caused half of the island's residents to never return and its population dropped from 9,800 to 4,900. Since 2003, 2 subsequent eruptions have occurred. The most recent of these ended in early 2013. Future eruptions will likely follow a rather predictable pattern which is common in the Caribbean. First, earthquake swarms will occur. Then, a lava dome is slowly built over several months. Eventually, this lava dome becomes so large that it collapses, thus generating a large explosion and pyroclastic flows. In a worst-case scenario, a lava dome collapse could also take part of the mountain with it. Although unlikely, this has happened at least once in the last 10,000 years. If you live on Montserrat, you should be fine as long as you stay north of the exclusion zone. Ancient volcanic activity in the center of the island acts as a natural barrier which protects the northern part of the island from pyroclastic surges of all but the largest eruptions. As a tourist, the island is safe to visit. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.